Offset link. Today in this video we will see how to design an offset link. Consider a simple offset link which should withstand a force P. We need to find out width and thickness of offset link. For this kinds of questions the following data may be given. Load withstand by link is P and is equal to 10 kN. Yield stress, which denoted as sigma, yt, is equal to 350 MPa. The ratio of width to thickness is given as 4, which can be rearranged as b equals 4 times t. Factor of safety is given as 4. And also the offset distance is given as 10 mm in the figure, and told to find out what should be the thickness and the width of the offset link. In this problem, first we need to find out the total stresses acting on the link. The stresses acting on link are of two type. Stress due to direct force and stress due to bending. Therefore the yield stress should be equal to sum of these two stresses. Yield stress is denoted by sigma yt, direct stress is denoted by sigma d, and bending stress is denoted by sigma d. First we will find out sigma direct. And we know direct stress is given as force upon area, which is nothing but P upon area, which is width, into thickness. Since we knew B is equal to 4 times T, by substituting we have direct stress is equal to P by 4 times T into T, which is T square. Now second we will find sigma bending, which is bending stress due to the offset. Sigma bending is given as M into Y upon I, where M is bending moment and is equal to force P into the total offset distance, which is 10 mm plus width divided by 2. Since we knew width is 4 times thickness, after substituting and simplifying we have M is equal to P into 10 mm plus 2 times T. Y is equal to width by 2. And if we put value of width as 4 times T and simplify we have Y is equal to 2T. And I is equal to moment of inertia. And for rectangular section it is given as thickness into width cube upon 12. And if we put the values and simplify we have I is equal to 16 t raised to 4 upon 3. Substituting all the values in bending stress we have the following equation, p into 10 mm plus width by 2 into 2t divided by 16 by 3 into t raised to 4. If we put the value of P, which is given as 10 kN, and B, as 4T, we have following equation. Now we will multiply and simplify the equation. Therefore, we get bending stress is equal to 37,500 by t cube plus 7,500 by t square. Since we found out direct stress and bending stress, now we'll see what is the yield stress or allowable stress for the given offset link. Yield stress for the material is given as 350 MPa and factor of safety is also given as 4. So to get allowable stress for the design, we divide 350 by 4. This is the allowable stress for the design, which is 87.5 MPa. Since we know total allowable stress should be equal to direct stress plus bending stress, we'll substitute all these values of stresses to get the thickness of the offset link. Therefore, we have 87.5 equals direct stress which P by 4T, which nothing but 10 kN upon 4T square, plus bending stress, which is 37,500 by T cube plus 7,500 by T square. After adding the similar terms we have the following equation. Now we will multiply by t cube throughout the equation. After multiplying and rearranging we have a cubic equation, which is 87.5 t cube minus 10,000 t minus 3,750 is equal to 0. Now if we solve this cubic equation, we get the value of t as 12.22 millimeters, which is thickness. Since we knew width is 4 times t. Therefore width is equal to 4 into 12.22, which is 48.88 millimeters. Hence we found out width and thickness of the offset link. Thanks for watching this video. Hope you have understood the concept. Don't forget to subscribe our channel and click on the bell icon to get the latest videos first. Also like and comment your opinions and share with your friends.